Salve, amigo.
One second. One or two. Wait, just a second. This is okay here.
So good afternoon, friends. Welcome back. This is Shailesh Saraf, Managing Director of Dynamic Equities Private Limited. So welcome to the new sessions. So we want to start. We have some good news now. We are doing very well in the small cap. Can you hear me? Is my voice clear? Yes? No? Can you hear me, everybody? Yes, yes. Shubham ji, Mr. Shubham, it's your issue. Please check your computer. Everybody can hear me. Shubham Ghule. Rest, all can hear me? Yes, yes. Okay, good. So, welcome back. Today, we have been doing very well in identifying small cap index, small cap shares, and giving it to you. So, you know, we will be now launching every quarter even large cap shares and even mid cap shares to you. Now, you know, before we start, let's understand the entire market. What is the whole market? What is the universe in India? So we are only studying NSE. You know, for because NSE comprises more than 95% to 96% of the shares, good shares listed. Only there are few shares which is has good volume and good fundamentals in BSE. So we are only sticking with NSE. So basically, in NSE there is 1569 shares listed. 1569 shares is listed. The total market capitalization of market is 1 lakh crores. 131 lakh crore is the total market capitalization of these 1500 shares. Out of this, 70% of the shares, the top 100 shares, uska market capitalization is 92 lakh crores. 92 lakh is the total market capitalization of top 100 shares in the country. Okay. जो नेक्स्ट 150 शेयर्स है उसका मार्केट कैपिटलाइजेशन इज 21 लाख 45 लाख करोड़, विच इज अबाउट 17% ऑफ द मार्केट, एंड द रेस्ट अप्रोक्सीमेटली 1329 स्टॉक्स. अगर आप देखेंगे 250 यहां से निकल गया, सो 250 निकल गया, 1319 स्टॉक्स, यू नो, इज अबाउट 13%. सो वी हैव आइडेंटिफाइड, we always give you a good list. Out of 1319 stocks, usually, you know, we give you the top 100 every quarter, top 80 stocks, top 90 stocks. Abhi bhi jo mera list hai, it has about 82 stocks, which is from 1319 stocks. So this list is our, you know, we give every quarter, and we give YouTube videos. Now from October to December quarter, we'll be releasing also, you know, 30 stocks for large cap and 50 stocks for mid cap every quarter, which you can invest if you're a large cap investor or you're a mid cap investor. Another thing which you want to, 6th October 2017, SEBI has issued a circular for all the mutual funds. So usme jo mutual funds hai, they, you know, the categories are not proper. So now SEBI has made a category, the top 100 stocks, which comprises of 92 lakhs crores, will be considered large cap stocks. Okay, so we'll be giving you a list ki abhi jo top 100 stocks hai market mein, which are the top 30 to invest in. Okay, SEBI has also said ki jo next 150 stocks honge, okay, after large cap, they will be put on mid cap stocks. So AMFI jo hai wo har 6 महीना में ये लिस्ट जो है ये अपने वेबसाइट में declare karega as per the new circular. But after the, this circular is implemented, every mutual fund will have proper thing, because abhi kya hai, most of the mutual funds is in multi-cap category, mid-cap, small-cap category. Un log large-cap bolte hai, but they have many, you know, mid-cap shares in that category. So most of the mutual funds come under multi-cap categories. So all these things will become very clear in the next 3 months. So by December 2017 and by March 2018, most of the mutual funds have to adhere to the new rule. So if it is a large cap, so they have to invest only in 100 stocks. Predominantly, they have to invest in 100 stocks that will be taken as large cap stocks. Okay. If they launch a mid cap mutual fund, they'll have to invest in 150 stocks. Okay. The rest 1390 stocks will come in small cap category. So this is very good. So this is actually the entire world also. Even if you study the US market, if you go to usnews.com, which has all the details, it is one of the best sites to study mutual funds, usnews.com. Usme bhi ye diya hua hai that 70% of the US market, they are considered the large cap stocks. So very similar to India, because India ka jo top 100 hai, 92 lakh crore, which is approximately 70% of the total market capitalization. Okay. So now India is also at par with the world, where there is no confusion, because there was a lot of confusion that what is a large cap stock, what is a mid cap stock, what is a small cap stock. So SEBI has made it very, very neat and clear. Okay. Everybody can hear me? Is it clear? Mr. Shubham Ghule cannot hear me. Yeah, so Shubham Ghule ji, it's your problem. Please check your, write the message to Shubham Ghule. Yes. Okay. So these are the new things. Okay. Another thing, jo small cap hai, hum log ka jo app hai, our app D levels, anything which is below 1000 crore market cap, we will say small cap mini. Okay. So we small cap, SEBI has identified all the shares which is after 250 stock, top 250 stock. SEBI has said it will be small cap stocks. We said it is all small cap, but below 1000, we'll just put it as small cap mini. So because you have to be very careful in investing in small cap mini stocks. Okay. You can invest and get give return, but you have to be very careful, because most of the investors get trapped when you invest in small cap mini stock, which is less than 1000 crore of market capitalization. Okay. So as an investor, you have to be very, very careful. So we choose about 20-25 stocks, which has very good fundamentals from small cap mini. And then only we give you in about 1300 stocks, which is in small cap, 450 stocks is in above 1000 crore, and about 850 stocks is below 1000 crore. So 50% of the stocks in the country is below 1000 crore, wherein an investor should be very, very careful. Okay. You should be very, very careful and investing in shares, which is in small cap mini. So the shares which we tell you from small cap mini, we do a lot of research and we tell you. Okay. So you have to be very careful in the investing in those stocks. Okay. So now we will show you the 100 stocks of large cap stocks where of the country today. So let's go large cap stocks alphabetically to get an idea that you have heard about the large cap stocks today. What are the ABCD? Yeah. Okay. So if you see the large cap stocks, you know, so ABB market cap.
Market cap
chahiye front mein.
फ्रंट में बात कर
फ्रंट में कॉपी तो करना है अपन हाइड कर दो ना सब
ठीक है सब हाइड कर
ओके सो इफ यू सी एबीबी 29,000 crore market cap, Adit Birla Capital, it's a new listing. 40,000 crore market cap, ACC, 30,000 crore, Adani Ports, 79,000 crore, Ambuja Cement, 53,000 crore, Ashok Leyland, 35,000 crore, Asian Paints, 1,10,000 crore, Aurobindo Pharma, 41,000 crore, Axis Bank, 1,22,000 crore, Bajaj Auto, 91,000, Bajaj Finserv, 84,000, Bajaj Holdings, 32,000, Bajaj Finance, 1,07,000 crore. So the Bajaj Group, if you see, has become a 3,00,000 crore company now. They have really done very well in the last 2-3 years. Bank of Baroda, 31,000 crore, Bharat Electronic, 54, Bharat Forge, 28, Bharti Airtel, 153. Bharat Heavy Electrical 30,000, Bosch 62, Bharat Petroleum 1,00,000, Britannia 52, Cadila Healthcare 48, Cipla 46, Coal India 168, Colgate 28, Container Corp 32, Dabur 54, DLF 29, Avenue Supermarket 68, Dr. Reddy 38, IHM Motors 84,000 crores, Gail India 73, Godrej 64, Gasim 54, Havells 30, HCL Technologies 122, you know, Housing Development Finance HDFC 280 lakh crores, HDFC Bank 4,65,000 crore, Hero Motocorp 76, Hindalco 54. Hindustan Petroleum 66, Hindustan Liver 256, Hindustan Zinc 132, ICICI Lombard 178, these are new listing again, 59,000 ICICI Prudential, Idea Cellular 27, Indigo, Interglobe Aviation 39,000 crore, Indusind Bank 1,01,000 crore, Bharti 75, Infosys 2,00,000 crore, Indian Oil Corporation 1,97,000 crore, ITC 3,17,000. So basically there is a full list. Okay, we had no. So these are the full list. We will also put so these are the top 100 shares which has. So we'll just put it so that you can also see slowly and gradually. So out of these 100 shares, now we'll be launching 30 shares every quarter, which we feel can give you the highest returns in the next quarter from December to. So if you're a large cap player, out of these 100 stocks, we have identified 30 stocks which are very, very good. Okay, so we'll be sharing the 30 stocks which we feel will give you a very, very good returns. Which are the 30 stocks for the October to December month? Okay, so highly recommend, you know, if you're not invested, if you're a large cap player, invest in Aurobindo Pharma, Bajaj Finserv, Bajaj Holding, Bajaj Finance, Bharat Electronics, Britannia, Container Corporation of India, DLF, Avenue Supermarkets, which is DMART, Gail, Grasim Industries, Hindustan Zinc, Indiabulls Housing Finance, Indusind Bank, L&T Finance Holding, Motherson Sumi, Oil India, Pyramal Enterprises, Power Finance Corporation, Pidilite Industries, Reliance Industries, Sri Cement, Sun TV Network, Tata Steel, Titan, TVS Motor, Ultratech Cement, Vakrangi, Vedanta and Yes Bank. So these are the 30 stocks which we recommend you should invest. Why are we recommending these 30 stocks? Let's go now in the research part of these 30 stocks. Go to main file and copy.
Phase wise.
Phase PAT growth and EBITDA growth.
Yeah,
and
PAT growth.
These are what are
we need to tax.
We need to hear. P.
Yeah.
PAT growth, EBITDA growth, sector.
Sector,
yeah. So why have we selected these stocks? You know, performance.
Performance. Phase wise.
What are you? 27 May. Yes.
Okay. 11th August. 23rd May. Second.
Okay. Now why L&T Housing has been selected? If you see why and why this company is growing. The PAT has grown 51% and it has really performed after thing. The P is 31. Okay. That is why this share has been selected. TVS Motor Company, if you see, it has been performing a lot. Okay. Current 27, 18, confused. We're just adjusting the $27.7 to current. Current I guess. Okay. Now if you study L&T Finance, 27 December se 131% bhar chuka hai. PAT growth is still good. Bajaj Finance, if you study, they are growing. They are a company which is growing quarter and quarter and year on year. Very good company. Bajaj Finserv, very good company, rising 94%. Still at a 36 P. Okay. In large cap, pehle small cap mein, we used to say don't invest in P which is above 30. But in small cap. But in large cap stocks, you know, certain companies which we have recommended because the sector is doing very well. Because the financial services is doing very, very well, that is why these shares have been recommended despite the P slightly being higher. Okay. Avenue Supermarket, Supermart, this P99 is not correct because we don't have the data of last four quarters. Because it's a new listing share and it's one of the favorite of mutual fund right now, that is why this has been recommended. Okay. DMart is very good. These companies have been recommended, okay, because they are in the right sector. And also the Q&Q and the PAT growth is very good. Okay. Indiabulls Housing, the P is very, very low. That is why it is recommended. It is growing on year on year. The company is very good. TVS Motor, okay, in the automobile sector, they are something related to electric vehicle may come. TVS Motor is a very good performer. It has risen 86%. The P is slightly higher, but still I feel that this company can do very well. Vakrangi, quarter and quarter, last six quarters, they are growing continuously. It's one of the best IT companies, which is growing continuously, risen 86%. So, and if you see, they are growing quarter and quarter and year on year, very, very high growth company, extremely high growth company. From the pharma, Piramal has been taken. It has risen 81%. Still it has, okay. If you see the P is slightly not very high compared to, but still it can be invested. Tata Steel, the metal sector, as we said in the last come, is doing very well. That is why it is recommended. Madison Sumi has been continuously doing well in the automobile sector. It has risen 64%. The year-on-year EBITDA is there in the company, but the performance is very good. Bajaj Holding, another financial services company because of the sector, and why very good. P is still very less in Bajaj Holdings. So when we select any share for in the 100 shares, four criteria is important. Number one criteria is sector. Number two is their the Y on Y and quarter growth and EBITDA growth, PAT growth. Number three is PAT. Number four is sector. And so these companies and performance. Sorry, four things: performance, sector, PE, and PAT growth and EBITDA growth. From four angles, we see and then we select certain companies into the company. Okay, then Sun TV Network, not very, very high growth. The P is low, but the share has been performing in media. Yes Bank has been continuously growing from six quarters. Quarter and quarter, it has been growing. A very good share. In banks, you don't get the EBITDA. But if you see YNY, the EBITDA is 32%. DLF has been selected because Realty has been doing very well as a sector. It has increased 55% from in this year up in 2017, and the Y on Y EBITDA has grown, which will reflect in the PAT growth also. Gale has risen 54%. Again, the Y on Y EBITDA is growing, and the P is pretty low, so go and invest. Britannia. Usually FMCG companies, pharma companies have high P ratios. Still recommended, not a very thing, but one of the only companies in food. So, and food as a sector is doing very well. That is where Britannia has been taken. Container Corporation, if you see Y&Y, there is a growth of 36% and 30%. So these companies is doing very well. The P is 35. Reliance Industry, definitely one of the best share to invest because of Jio. 16%, and the company is still growing. It's such a large company growing on Y and Y, and EBITDA is fantastic. So definitely Reliance Industries. Vedanta is doing very well on Y and Y. If you see, the growth is 96% in PAT and 79%. Okay, the P is still very low. The P is only 14. Grasim, very good share again, 14 P, good growth also. Shri Cement, cement industry is doing very well. Okay, it has been done slightly P high. Pidilite, Fevicol, the P is high. The company quarter to quarter is growing. Y and Y is not very good. Bharat Electronics. Okay, Bharat Electronics 31%. Hindustan Zinc. Ultratech Cement, cement company is growing. Aurobindo Pharma, All India and Finance Corporation. So, you know, it's a tough selection out of 100 large cap stocks. It's a tough selection. So there are certain companies which have slightly high P ratio, but because you select 30 companies, so some P ratio is high selection because they are in the right sector. And the results are also very good. And that the companies are doing well, good performance also. So we'll show you the P from smallest to largest. So if you see, out of 30 stocks, 26 are below 50. Only 7 total.
19 are below.
Total stocks.
23
are below 50. And some of the stocks, 7 stocks we have selected, which is slightly above 50. Please do not take Avenue Sepuma 99 because it's a new listing. So as the results will come, the P will get adjusted. And it's a favorite mutual fund stock. Okay. So some of the stocks which has been taken, which is in the hold category, but their performance are very, very well. Like cement, financial services, realty, gold and jewelry, food. So because the sectors are doing very well and the share performance is doing very well, that is why some of the stocks we have taken. So it's up to you. So if you don't want to invest in these stocks, you can go for low P stocks also. So Bajaj Holding, Grasim, Vedanta, Hindustan Zinc, Reliance, India Bulls, Oil, Power Finance, Aurobindo Pharma, Tata Steel, Yes Bank, Gale. These are companies which is still very, very low P stocks. Very, very low P stocks right now. Okay, so you can invest in these stocks actually. So these are 30 stocks which we recommend. which we feel can give the a good return from October to December for 3 months. Then obviously we have to rebalance our portfolio every 3 months, and we'll give you a new stock. We will be launching, like we have launched a small cap index, we'll be launching a large cap index probably in 3 months. We are doing a lot of research so that we can beat the mutual fund returns regularly. Okay, so this is the story behind large cap. Now we will study mid cap stocks. Okay, so 150 stocks, as per the SEBI circular, after 100 stocks, the next 150 stocks will be categorized as mid cap stocks. So all the mutual funds, they have to launch a mid cap index, mid cap mutual fund, or a small cap mutual fund, or a large cap mutual fund. Two other mutual funds also they can launch, which will be known as the multi cap fund, which will have, they can invest in any stock. Okay. And one will be a large cap, mid cap index mutual fund. So we have categorized three right now. So in 150 stocks of mid cap, we'll also give you 50 good mid cap stocks to invest every quarter. This will also come in an app in about a week's time. The large cap is already there. So we'll also launch a mid cap category and launch 50 stocks for you so that you can invest in the right mid-cap stocks every quarter. Okay, so basically these are the 150 stocks market cap. So this is an Excel we work. So again, we'll just leave it for, we'll just go slow by slow. So when you can see the video again. AIG Engineering, Ajanta Pharma, Asco Noble, Alchem, Amaraja, Alembic, Apollo, Apollo Tires, Arvind, Ashai Glass, Astra Poly, AU Small Finance, Avanti Feed, Balkrishna Industries, Bank of India, Bata India, Beer Corp Rides, Bombay Burma, Berger Paint, Bharat Financial, Biocon, Blue Dart, Canara Bank, Castrol, Central Bank of India, Century Textile, Calcutta Electric, Cholamandalam, Coromandel, Crisil, Crompton, City Union, Cummins, Dalmia Bharat, Dilip Buildcon, Devan Housing, DVS Laboratory, Edelweiss, Imami, Endurance, Ingenious India. These are all the 150 stocks we are going through. Escorts, Excite, Future, Consumer, Federal Bank, Finance Label, Future Retail, GTD India, Gillette, GlaxoSmithKline, Glenmark, GMR Infrastructure, Godrej Industries, Godrej Properties, Groove Finance, Glaxo, Gujarat State, Gujarat Gas, Hatsun Agro, Honeywell, Hausen, India Bulls Real Estate, India Bulls Venture, IDBI Bank, IDFC Bank, Indraprastha Gas, IFL, India Infoline, India Hotels, Indian Bank, ITI, Jindal Steel, GM Financial, GSW Energy, Jubilant Life Science, Jubilant Food, Kajira Ceramic, Kansai Neurolac, Karur Vaishya, KIOCL, KRBL, Larsen Toubro, Mahindra, Mahindra Financial and Mahindra Automotive. So there is one Mahindra in the large cap, and these are two different Mahindras. Mannapuram Finance, Max, Mahanagar, Mindtree, Motilal Emphasis, Mangalore Refinery, Muthoot Finance, Natco Pharma, National Aluminium, InfoEdge, National Building, LLC, Obora Realty, Page Industry, PC Jewelers, Pfizer, PI Industries, PNB, Prestige, Quest, Rajesh Gold, Ramco, RBL, Reliance Capital, Reliance Infrastructure, Reliance Power, Steel, Authority, Sale, Sanofi, Scaffer India, Shriram City Union, SGVN, Solar Industry, Sun Pharma, SRF, Shriram Transport, Stellar Technologies, Sundaram Creighton, Sundaram Finance, Sundaram Fasteners, Supreme Industries, Suzlon, Symphony, Sygene, Tata Chemical, Tata Communication, Tata Global, Tata Power, Thermax, Thomas Cook, EI Financial, Torrent Pharma, Torrent Power, Trent, United Beverage, Union Bank, Varun Beverage, Voltage, Vapco India and Whirlpool. So we went through 150 shares purposely so that when you see that this video will be uploaded on YouTube, you can see the 150 shares. So these are the mid-cap shares, okay, which has a total PPT. Okay, these mid-cap shares has a total, they constitute of 17% of total market capitalization, or yet 150 company ka total market cap hai 21.45 lakh crores. Okay, so out of these 150 companies, we will give you 50 companies to invest in. So according to the new SEBI circular, these 100 stocks and these 150 stocks will be given by AMFI in their website every quarter, every 6 months, June ended and March, December, May, they will release these stocks. More or less, these should be the same stocks because we have taken it from market capitalization. So once you have these 150 stocks, you can define your strategy and you can invest in the top 50 stocks. So this quarter, we are giving you 50 stocks, which we feel can give you the maximum return in the next one quarter. So if you're a mid-cap player, you can invest in these 50 multibaggers. So which one we think is, we think Adani Enterprises, Adani Transmission, Ashai India, or Small Finance Bank, Avanti Feed, Balkrishna Industries, Bata India, Century Textiles, Calcutta Electric, Coromandel International, City Union Bank, Dilip Buildcon, Divan Housing, Divi's Laboratories, Edelweiss, Endurance Technologies, Escorts, Federal Bank, Future Retail, Gru Finance, Gujarat Gas, Housing and Urban Development Corporation, India Bulls, Indraprasad Gas, IFL Holdings, Indian Bank, JM Financial, JSW Energy, Kajaria Ceramics, Kansai Nerolac, Karur Vysya, KIOCL, KRBL, Manappuram Finance, Motilal Oswal, Mangalore Refinery, Muthoot Finance, National Aluminium Company, PC Jeweler, PNB Housing Finance, Prestige Estate, Rajesh Exports, RBL Bank, Reliance Capital, Stellar Technologies, Sundaram Finance, Sundaram Fasteners, Tata Global Beverages, Torrent Power and Voltas. So we feel that these 50 companies out of 150 will give you the maximum returns in the next quarter. Okay, so now let's study the result, you know, why these 50 stocks have been selected out of 150 stocks. Again, four criteria has been taken: sector, PE, profitability quarter and quarter, year on year, and performance. So when we balance four things, we come out with good quality alpha stocks, quality and growing stocks, which can give you very, very good returns. Mr. Josh Smith and Mr. Rahul Soni, this Excel, you know, we develop, and if you want to learn about this Excel, you cannot get this Excel, but if you want to learn how to make these things, you have to come for the training program, which I'm having in Mumbai from 11th and 12th. Okay, so we'll be training you how to make, you know, how to identify more clearly these stocks in a detailed presentation. So if you're interested, please give your phone number or your email, you know, and my person will contact you. We'll also be sharing in the program day after tomorrow in Bombay, 2-day program, which I will be personally doing, which is the ultimate exit strategy. Okay, So the ultimate exit strategy is where you can learn how to exit your counters. So we will be teaching you how you can exit your shares, so that because the markets are very high. So if you know the exit strategy properly, you can exit your counters. So that is very important thing which a investor should learn, which I will be teaching on 11th and 12th October, day after, on so that you can learn about how to make everything, how to make the entire details. It's not an online course. We have to travel to Bombay to do this course, but it will be really worth it. If you will come, it will be really worth it. And we will teach you how to select the 100 stocks of small cap, which can give you very, very good returns. The new companies which are growing. Okay, Mr. Rahul, it is very 3 hours from Mumbai is only 3 hours, so you can easily travel. Okay, so let's study why these stocks have been selected and why we think that these stocks can give you very good returns. So new listing shares, All Bank, Endurance, Hudco, full name. This is a and PMB Housing Finance. These are shares which has been listed in the last 6 to 8 months, 9 months. So new listing shares, usually the P is not correct. Okay, so don't go by the P for new listing shares because they have not declared 4 results. Okay, but these shares are doing very well in their performance also. So these shares we highly recommend that you should invest in. Or Small Bank, Endurance Technologies, Housing and Urban Development Corporation, Hudco, Kudeshwar, which is in metals, it's a very good company, and PNB Housing Finance. Okay, Avanti Feeds is one of the favorite stocks because it's a very good sector. The company is growing at a very fast rate. So it is one of our favorite stocks which we have been giving in our previous thing also. But now this has come into mid-cap category. Okay, so next time you will not get this share in the small cap category. It will be given in the mid-cap category, which is Avanti Feeds. Future Retail, after demonetization, all the departmental shows have done very well. It's one of the favorites for IDFC Mutual Fund. So it's a very good company. Slightly the P is higher, but the company is growing. Their PAT is growing very good. Okay. Okay. Okay, so if you see Future Retail, okay, it is growing at, and it is slightly, the P is higher, but if you see in the last 8-9 months, it has risen 333%, but still I recommend this share. Indiabulls Real Estate, Indiabulls Group is doing very well. Real Estate, it is growing at a very fast rate, and Realty is doing very well. Edelweiss, Motilal Oswal, India Infoline. Amazing three companies doing very well. Okay. If you see, they are growing. Adani Transmission, because if the performance is very good, so we have taken one power company
and mutual fund,
and it's one of the favorite mutual fund. Dilip Buildcon in infrastructure has done very well. If you see, they are growing year on year. The growth is fantastic. Okay. Motilal Oswal, from last 6 quarters, it is growing. So very, very good counter. India Infoline, Sterilite Technologies, another favorite of Reliance Capital Mutual Fund. Because Jio is doing very well, Reliance Capital, Sterilite Technologies, if you see year on year growth is tremendous. Divan Housing Financial Services, growing very good, amazing performance. Escorts. Escorts, again growing company. Okay, Ashai India, it's because it's growing slightly, P is higher, but still a very big favorite of mutual funds. Okay, so we are recommending certain counters which are slight, but there is a reason. Okay, GM Financial, Again, financial services, Rajesh exports gold and jewelry. You know, Karur Vysya Bank, okay, in the bank sector, this has given a fantastic return in the last 9 months. PC Jewelers continuously growing quarter and quarter. A very good gold share. Jabhi bhi bazaar niche jata hai, we see the price of PC Jewelers rising. Okay. Muthoot Finance, a great company. Federal Bank, another great company doing very well. KRBL in food, growing company, high growth, less P. Tata Global Beverages, Gujarat Gas. If you see the results of Gujarat Gas, tremendous high growth company. The results are financial. The Indraprasan Gas, Prestige in reality is doing very well. If you see,
jumped very well.
You know, if you year on year, what they are growing. Okay, Voltas, not a great company, but still the performance is very well in the infrastructure space. Grew Finance, financial services, the sector is very well. Bata India in the consumer sector, high growth company, quarter and quarter, year on year growth. Okay, Coromandel in fertilizer, if you see the year on year growth is fantastic. Kajaria Ceramic has been giving country, the results are not very good, but the performance is very good. In the interior construction, you know, the performance is good. The results are not so good right now. Okay. So, but still the company, one of the favorite companies for us. So we are giving Calcutta Electric, growing at a very fast rate again. Balkrishna Industries in automobiles. Okay. Adani Enterprises, again, because it's a, the company is growing, that's why we have given this share. The PAT growth is not very great, but the P is very less. So we have selected this counter from the P level. Sundaram Fasteners, Manappuram Finance, RBL Bank, Sundaram Finance. Sundaram Finance is one of the best mutual funds, you know, people invest in. Very reliable mutual fund. Kansai Nerolac, company growing. Then Mangalore Refinery. The results are not good, but the P is very less. In energy oil sector, somehow this share is doing very well. Okay, City Union Bank, National Aluminium Company. Okay, the Y&Y on the EBITDA is good. Reliance Capital. Okay, the P is still very less in Reliance Capital, that's why it has been selected. JSW Energy, Indian Bank, Torrent Power, and DV's Lab. DV's Lab has been recently in pharma, has done very well. The results are not very good, the P is less, but it has been selected because the price performance somehow is doing very well. So if you see out of P, out of 50 companies, 30 के ऊपर twenty-eight companies are above below 30 P, so very very good. Now the other companies you can choose, you know, till 50 you can choose. 15 companies are there where the P is slightly higher, but there are certain companies which are in good sector and they are performing, high growth companies, that is where they have been taken. And then these companies, two have been taken on the basis of new listing, and few companies have been taken because their performance and mutual fund is showing a lot of interest in these companies. So there has to be a balance. Some companies which has been taken from hold. So if you will go to our app, these companies, some companies have been taken for hold, this is recommended. But if you don't want to invest, you can select the buy companies and invest also. Okay. But we give some of the hold companies which we feel where there is a lot of interest and the results can also be good in future. So these are the 50 companies which is doing very, very well in the last, we feel that these 50 companies will outperform the market and will give tremendous good returns for you. So think of investing in these 50 companies, and we have given you a list of 150 companies. We'll also give you a brief idea, how do we select? So basically, when you go to 150 companies, okay, first we see which companies. Which companies are giving quarter and quarter and year on year growth, which we mark as blue. So out of 150 companies, about 36 companies, they are growing on quarter and quarter and year on year. 36 companies, they are growing quarter and quarter and year on year. Okay, now yellow companies are, which is growing on year on year. How many shares are there? Jada. 27 companies are growing year on year. Okay. So out of about 68 companies, their results are very, very good. So we study these 68 companies and try to select most of the companies from this, because they know that the results are very good. At least they are growing year on year and quarter and quarter also. So one of the major reasons for selecting is the results. The second counter we do is from this, then we check the PE. Which are the companies which is the lowest PE still in the market? Because there is a lot of fear. Less than 30. How many companies are there? So out of 150 companies, about 66 companies have PE less than 30. So there is another major criteria which we study for small cap and mid cap and large cap. Okay. Then we also study the performance, that which are the top 50 companies which has grown maximum in the last 8-9 months. These are the new listing which will not come. So IB Ventures, if you see, more companies, top 50 companies. IB Ventures is the one company which has grown by 1263% from 1st January till today, which is about 9.5 months. Okay, Avanti Feed 366, Future Retail 333, India Bulls, ITI. So there is a balance. So from performance, from results, from P, and also from sector, that which sectors are doing very well, which we showed you in the last presentation. So from this, we select about 50 stocks and give it to you, which we feel, which will give you the highest returns for the next one quarter. Okay. So these are some of the strategies which we follow. And the detailed about this strategy will be given you on 11th and 12th October. So if you're interested, you can, you know, come for the training program for 2 days and understand the entire details and become a good fundamental investor. So if you're interested to invest in large cap, there will be a good training which will be giving you that how large, what is a large cap and what are the risk parameters for large cap? What is mid cap? What are the risk parameters for mid cap? In small cap, the risk parameters are higher so that we don't get trapped. So we will give you the training program in such a way that whatever you feel comfortable with, you can invest in those counters. If you feel that you just want to invest in blue chip companies, then you can invest in the top 30 companies. If you want to invest in mid cap companies, which has approximately most of the mid cap, there we checked most of the mid cap, their market capitalization is more than 7,500 crores. So you can invest in those shares. And then small cap, you have to be more careful. But in small cap, in these 250 companies, most of the companies, you may have heard the name. But when we will give you the training program on 11th and 12th October on small cap, you may not have heard the names of those companies also. So that will be a brilliant learning, that those are the new companies which will become great companies in India. Okay, so if you can identify those companies right now and you can hold it for 2-3 years, then you can make big money. So those small cap companies, we also give you training, but you have to be careful. The risk parameters are slightly higher for small cap companies so that you don't get trapped. Also, below 1000 crore market capitalization, you have to be very, very careful. Okay, because most of the companies can be very dangerous for investment purposes. So this training is also given to you so that you never get stuck in the wrong share. Okay, it, when you invest in shares listed on BSE, you have to be very, very careful. According to our research, there are only 30-40 companies apart from NSE which is good to invest. That is why we only keep our research to NSE right now. So you have to be very, very careful in investing in certain companies which you might get trapped as an investor. Okay, so this is, you know, some of the strategies. Again, as I wanted to review, 1569 stocks listed on NSE. The top 100 market is 92 lakh crores, 150 stocks 21 lakh crores, and approximately 1319 stocks in 17 lakh crores. Okay, so every quarter we'll be giving you list. So this is where the maximum money is. So once you can identify a good small cap share and invest into it, which has good fundamentals, that gives you the highest returns in your investment. But if your risk appetite is low and you want to be 100% sure that, you know, that these companies cannot do any harm to you, then you invest in large cap and mid cap companies, top 250 companies of India, whether those companies are very large, so the risk is very less, but the returns are also very less. But we try to identify good companies which can give you good returns in the next quarter. Okay, so these are some of our strategies which you can learn. And you know, you can go to our YouTube channel. This video will be uploaded in my YouTube channel, Shailesh Saraf. We have a Android and iOS app. Please download our app, D-Levels, and our website is dynamiclevels.com. And you can contact in this number and send your mail if you're interested. Okay. And also the exit strategy is very, very important. So we will also give you training that how you, the open interest is given by NSE every day. So how you can exit from the open interest. We also give you that how from the cash market, there is certain indicators which can give you indicating fundamental indicators, which will tell you that you might have a correction in the market. So if you learn those indicators and the open interest, then you can have a very good exit strategy also, which we will teach you on 11th and 12th. Okay, so we will teach you large cap stocks, mid cap stocks, small cap stocks. We will also give you a very good list of mini cap stocks, small cap mini, which can give you, which gives a return of sometime 200-300% a year also. So you can invest in those stocks also. On, we will give you those training on 11th and 12th October. Okay, so thank you very much for your time and effort. And if you want to give your name and address, email address, my person can contact you if you want to learn on 11th and 12th, or the, you can be in touch. We also have a, we have also launched a new index. Rain Industries is a very good share. It's one of our favorite, Kamleshji. So you can definitely invest in Rain Industries, one of our favorite shares in the small cap. It's a very, very good share. Yes, we still recommend Rain, and you can invest in Rain still. There's no problem. Okay. And we also have a PMS. So you can give an investment of 25 lakhs, and we manage PMSs also. and we have been giving the highest returns in PMS. So if you're interested to know our performance, you can give your email, my people can give you and tell you our performance. So we have been beating the all the mutual fund returns and all the, you know, returns in the last 1 year. We've also launched a new index. We also have a new index, dynamic small cap index, which we have launched, which you can see on our website. So this is the new launch. This index is managed by National Stock Exchange team. So this index is managed by them, and we invest in 100 shares in this index in the PMS. So if you want all the details, you can go, you can download our app and you can study and be in touch. So, and you invest in our shares, which we recommend to you, and you see how your returns goes. Okay. Thank you very much. So if anybody wants to give the phone number or address, my people can contact you. Thank you so much. Namaste. Happy investing. I hope you like the seminar. If you like, please say, you know, you liked it, so we'll be very thankful to you. Thank you, Mr. Ashok. If anybody wants to share the email or phone number, so they can contact you. If you want to share your email or phone number, if you want anybody to contact you. Mr. Shalaka Bartake, you can come to Mumbai. It's not very far, you will learn a lot. The minimum PMS amount is, Mr., 25 lakhs as per SEBI norms. So you have to invest 25 lakhs. Please share, Mr. Ranjan and Shalaka, please share your email addresses and phone numbers. So whenever we have in Bangalore, we can contact you. So please share your phone numbers and email so we can contact you, Mr. Shalaka and Mr. Ranjan, when we have in Bangalore. But Bangalore. Please, Mr. Rahul Mirchanan, please share. Ahmedabad is not very far from Bombay, so we request you to come to Bombay. So please share your email address and phone number. We'll contact you for Ahmedabad also. Okay, so thank you. Namaste. Welcome.